Welcome to Gunston.
Thank you.
And also the Indian elephant walks. Pardon? The Indian elephant walks. And Africa, no. Not domestic anymore.
Wow, that's a good shot.
When you come here in rain season, you won't see this white stuff. It will be washed all in the water.
The first night we were at Gunn's camp, we were awakened at about 12:30 by a marauding elephant, a hungry elephant, as he tromped and ate his way through our camp of five cabins. The Jurassic Park sights, sounds, and smells were intriguing until all of a sudden the girl across the way screamed bloody murder. Her parents sounded the emergency foghorn and the guides came running, but nothing could scare him off. That night will be one of my most memorable of the entire trip.
Ted reads
rock. Rock, okay.
Most of the time when we do the walking, we prefer to respect animals. We don't go closer to an animal. We prefer to stay away, about 100 to 150 meters away from us. And we prefer, if it's possible, to stick downwind. Still see some grass on it that's not been digested. And this one also, see how it is? And if you look here, this one, the shape of the dropping is kidney shaped.
This is the Botswana's national animal. This one you see them on the photo.
the snakes, they keep on shedding the skin. And they drop the seeds on the fork of this tree. From there, when the rain starts raining, it germinates. From there, it sends what we call the aerial root. This is what we call an African ebony. Yeah, if you kill an animal in water here,
back after our walk.